Now, we have to consider the chapter successive differentiation. So, let us understand what is meant by the successive differentiation. For example, we have a function. Suppose we have a function y is equal to f of x. Now, we differentiate this function and we get dy by dx is equal to y1 is equal to f dash of x. Now, again, differentiate this and we get d2y by dx square is equal to y2. This is equal to f double dash of x. Again, we differentiate this derivative and we get dqy by dx cube is equal to y3 is equal to f triple dash of x. Now, if I differentiate this third derivative, we get d raised to 4y by dx raised to 4 is equal to y4 is equal to fourth derivative of x. And now, if we go on differentiating this way, then we can have the nth derivative, that is y dny by dx raised to n is equal to yn is equal to fn x. So what we have to do is we have to consider first few derivatives, then we have to observe the pattern in these derivatives, and then after observing the pattern, we have to generalize the nth derivative. So we have to generalize this pattern for yn, and this process is called successive differentiation. Now let us see the first example of successive differentiation.